Hi, it's Tom Dahlman here with Core Group Realty. Just wanted to take a minute and share some interesting design stuff that's happening with Innovative Custom Home. This is Heather Echevarria. I've asked her to come and share one of her projects with us. Actually, there's going to be two projects that we're going to show you, kind of phase one and phase two. But Heather, tell us about this first one.
Well, this one, phase one, is actually where we've gone through and completely demolished, you know, all the interior walls. As you can see, it's a very open floor plan. We will start phase two, which is once we get the construction permits, we will start rebuilding it. This one is going to get a second story, an attached garage, and where we're standing right now will be the new backyard instead of the front of the house and driveway. So it's a fun project.
Yeah, they're actually changing the address on this so that it's not on the 36th Street, but on the other side street, so that the orientation of the house is completely changed as well.
And the safety feature of it, you know, is the biggest thing, is because backing out onto 36th Street is not great. Backing out onto Hanson, that's a much safer way to go.
Cool. Well, let's check it out a little bit, and then we'll go show you a phase two project that she's working on as well. All right, we're here at a house on 21st Street that Heather is in phase two of, kind of in that drywall phase, but wanted her to share a little bit about where they're at and in the process.
All right, well, this house behind us started out as a 1930s home, single level. You can see it's got a detached garage on it, and you know, we took it all down to studs, got rid of all of the lead-based paint, and all that other stuff, and now it's got brand new siding and a brand new interior with a second story, and we refinished the basement in this one. So it's a really cool project that, like Tom said, we're in phase two.
So like the last one, they took it down all the way to the studs, got that open floor plan on it so that they could go back in and recreate it in their own image.
Yeah, so it's a fun project to do, go in and open them up. So essentially, you're getting a brand new house down here in the North End, which is really, really hard to find.
Let's go inside and check it out. All right, here we are inside the house on 21st Street, so you guys can kind of see what phase two looks like in the drywall process. Tell us a little bit more about this house, Heather.
So this house will end up being just over 3,100 square feet. It's got the main level, and then we've got an upstairs with three more bedrooms, laundry room, bathroom. Main level has the master suite, a guest suite or office, and then obviously, you know, your kitchen, living, access to the backyard, and then we've got the basement that's got another bedroom, so 3, 4, 5, possibly a 6-bedroom house.
Wow.
Down here in the North End, but we've got it set up as a theater room down in the basement, little homework play area, and all new drywall, all new windows. We're in the drywall phase right now. They actually just got done sanding, so it's a little bit foggy in here.
Just a little bit. So how long does a project like this usually take when you go into a house and actually pull them out and renovate it completely like this?
So when we first buy the project, we start demoing it. That's phase one. That usually takes us about 2 months to demo it and come up with our plans. And then phase two is submitting for our permits for the reconstruction and adding, and that takes us about 4 months. So overall, we're about 6 to 7 months on something to this extent.
And how long have you been doing this kind of remodel and rebuilding and so forth?
Well, you know, we started remodeling homes in 1999.
Wow.
So that's 17 years ago. So it's been a fun process. We started with remodeling, and then we moved into new construction, and then we've kind of come back to our roots. and doing these major remodels they're so much fun. You can be so creative and, you know, working within the existing footprint, coming up with more of an updated plan is really a lot of fun.
Now we're at the end of the project, and I wanted Heather to tell you a little bit about finishing up this beautiful piece of property.
So as you can see, we got the landscaping in. The interior is on its final completion days, cleaning and staging and all those fun things. The lighting is all in, which I'm very, very
gorgeous.
Excited about. Backyard is very cool and features a fire pit. It's been kind of a long process for us at 7 months. But, you know, with what this thing started out as,
to what it's finished out as. It's a really cool transformation.
Yeah, it's very beautiful inside. Tell us a little bit about the what you kind of put in, what kind of flooring, countertops and stuff like that.
So the flooring throughout the, most of the house, the main level, is that recycled PVC flooring. Lifetime warranty, you know, pet proof, child proof, husband proof. I mean, it's great flooring.
It's everything proof.
It's everything proof. Has a lifetime warranty, like I said. I love it. We used it in our parade house as well. I have it in my personal home, so I absolutely love it. Countertops are a beautiful white quartz. Chrome fixtures throughout. Like I said, the lighting, which I had a lot of fun shopping for. I always love shopping for lighting, and it's so cool when it turns out like I'm envisioning it. And a really nice carpet with the basement. You know, we wanted a really nice pad underneath the nice carpet so it doesn't feel like you're walking on concrete. So overall, it's just turned out to be a great project, and we're very, very proud of it.
Tell us a little bit about what you're coming on the market list price-wise, and share that with the audience as well.
So we are listed at just under 700,000 right now. We're 3,103 square feet, I believe, per our plans. So the home started as a single level with a basement. We completely gutted it, got rid of all the siding, all the old insulation, because it was a 1920s home. And then we made the exterior walls 2x6. And but went up an additional level, adding another 3 bedrooms, laundry room, storage galore in this house.
Lots of storage.
Lots of insulation, lots of storage, brand new heating. It really is a new, never occupied home at this point.
Yeah, and it's a big lot too. There's a lot of property here for a North End home. What's the acreage here?
I think they said it's like 0.25, but it feels so much bigger than that for a 3,000 square foot home. You know, you've got RV parking here in the front. There's also additional parking in the back with alley access. Just a huge, huge backyard. And then, you know, we added a fire pit last minute just because I thought it needed a fire pit back there in that backyard.
Yeah, and it's a beautiful fire pit too. So check it out. You can click the link below to go see the property itself and also to view any other homes. Feel free to reach out to us if you have any questions about the property itself or would like to schedule a showing, and we'll talk to you soon. Thanks a lot. Thank you, Heather, for joining me.
Thank you.